Why is the scoring in the NBA down this year? Let's take a look. NBA scoring is down this season, and it's not just free throws. This season, the average offensive rating in the NBA is 106.2, which is points scored per 100 possessions, using Basketball Reference's numbers. Last season, it was 112.3. During the bubble season, it was 110.6. The season before that, it was 110.4. Through the first 2 weeks of this NBA season, scoring is down, way down. 6.1 points per 100 possessions compared to the season before. For a league that has leaned towards opening up the offense and letting the athleticism and skill of its players shine, it's an unexpected trend. What's causing the drop? The easy line to draw is to point the change in foul calls around the league. James Harden, Trae Young, and others are not getting whistles for non-basketball moves, and their free throws are down. Across the league, we're seeing 3.6 fewer free throw attempts per game this season, and compared to the last pre-COVID season, free throw attempts are down 6.2 per game. However, talk to players and they point to something bigger than the referees. This is the second NBA season coming off a shortened offseason, and players point to reduced time for their bodies to recover and work on skill development. The Bucks closed out the Phoenix Suns on July 20th, a whole month later than the traditional NBA Finals ends. Yet the league wanted to get back on its regular schedule, so the season tipped off on October 19th. That's a month less time to rest and recover. The season before that was the bubble championship for the Lakers, then a rushed offseason to start games in time for Christmas. Players say that they're feeling the effects. Some top NBA scorers also got off to slow starts this season due to injury, including Harden and Damian Lillard. Maybe the offensive numbers will tick up around the league as the season wears on, but the pandemic took a toll on just about everything we know and love over the past couple years. We're still dealing with the fallout. NBA scoring appears to simply be part of that trend. The short off seasons to get back to normal have come at a cost. Next up, the shorthanded Milwaukee Bucks have dropped 3 straight games. On paper, it should have been a good early season measuring stick game. The defending champion Bucks against maybe the hottest team in the league to start the season, the Utah Jazz. Instead, it was a third straight game to forget for Milwaukee as they fell to Utah 107-95. It's not hard to see why when you look at the Bucks injury report. Jrue Holiday misses 4th straight game with an ankle injury, Brook Lopez misses 6th straight game with a back issue, Chris Middleton was ill and missed the game against the Jazz, and Dante DiVincenzo has yet to play the season following foot surgery that sidelined him last playoffs. Without Lopez as the drop-back center protecting the rim, and without the strong defensive Holiday at the point of attack, the Milwaukee defense has fallen to 24th in the NBA. The Bucks' offense has been pretty average this season as well, but when they struggled on that end in years past, they could always count on an elite defense to carry them in games. Not so far this season, with so many key players out. The Bucks' fortunes will turn once they get healthy, but it has been a rough patch to open the season. Utah continues to roll, 5-1 with a top-5 offense and defense to start the season. They are healthy and on top of the West standings, where they will likely be for most of this campaign. Up next, James Harden is finding his groove, Kevin Durant ejected in Nets win. Remember that slump that James Harden was in to start the season? The one that everyone wanted to blame on the new foul call enforcement and the drop-in free throws? It's over. James Harden is back. Harden had a triple-double on Sunday against the Pistons with 18 points, 12 assists, and 10 rebounds, 2 days after he scored 29 and got to the free throw line 19 times in a win over the Pacers. Harden is back to attacking, and you can see the confidence grow game to game. He looks like himself once again. Behind Harden, Brooklyn had little trouble keeping the Pistons winless, taking the game 117-91. Kevin Durant led the Nets in scoring with 23 points, but he was ejected in the third quarter when he got his elbow up to the neck of Kelly Olynyk. Durant was tracking Sadiq Bey, who was moving to the top of the key, when Olynyk set a screen and KD did too much trying to fight through it. The Nets went on an 11-0 run after Durant was ejected, and the game was never in doubt after that. Well guys, thank you so much for joining us for this video. Be sure to smash that like button, subscribe to Swish Position, and hit that notification bell so that you never miss a video. See you all next time.